Welcome to the hottest movie review on the internet today, the A-List Review. I am your host, the Game Changer, Wes Troop. And today I'm here with a review of a movie that came out in theaters, a couple weeks back. Oddly enough, it didn't come to either one of my theaters around me, so I had to wait, and randomly, it popped up this past weekend. I didn't even know it was there. I was like, oh, okay, I have to see this now. So, that's my excitement for this movie. I guess I gotta see it. Ladies and gentlemen, my review of the 2018 romantic comedy remake, Overboard, coming up now. Selfish playboy Leonardo, a member of Mexico's richest family, has an encounter with Kate, the single mom of three hired to clean his yacht and isn't exactly impressed. Leo fires Kate and refuses to pay her. After too much partying, he falls overboard, and when he wakes up, he finds himself stranded on the Oregon coast with amnesia. Kate soon finds out and decides to pass herself off as his wife to try to get some payback on Leo. He soon finds himself trying to take on the role of husband and father to the family. So what did I think of Overboard? I thought it's an average romantic comedy. This is obviously a remake of the 1987 film that starred Goldie Hawn and Kurt Russell. In this version, the roles are reversed, however, where the man is the wealthy one and the woman is trying to take advantage of the situation. It's also an international movie made for both American and Mexican audiences, starring the very popular Eugenio Derbez, which is a pretty smart move. The comedy is hit and miss, with a few highlights being some physical comedy from Derbez, and unfortunately, I never really found myself laughing out loud, but only letting out a couple chuckles here or there. There are a number of good heartfelt moments thrown in, which do work between Leo and Kate, and also Leo and the kids as they bond throughout the film. The chemistry between the two leads is fine, and I did find myself rooting for the two of them to get together in the end. The story is very predictable, taking us down that oh-so-familiar romantic comedy road where we can easily guess what will happen next, beat for beat, whether it be Leo getting along with the girls or the characters learning certain lessons. There's also a lame subplot featuring Leo's family with his sister who's trying to take over the family business that weighs down the movie every time it cuts back to it. Clocking in close to 2 hours, the movie does feel long, and there's a lot of things that could have easily been left on the cutting room floor. Oddly enough, Kate isn't really given much to do towards the middle of the film, almost becoming a side character, and there's also a pretty big number of supporting characters who don't really add much to the movie at all. The cast gives some fine performances, starring Eugenio Derbez as Leonardo, the egotistical playboy who's suffering from amnesia, Anna Faris as Kate, the single mom who's hurting for money and lies to Leo in order to get some help around the house, Eva Longoria as Teresa, Kate's friend who actually comes up with the whole scheme, and John Hanna as Colin, Teresa's husband who gets Leo a job doing construction work. Overboard is a remake that didn't really need to be remade, and while it's a pretty old hat, the cast makes it at least tolerable. I'm gonna give it the rating of meh. You know, it's okay. Alright, well that's the show. I'll be back with another review very soon. But until then, don't forget to subscribe right here on YouTube. YouTube.com/WestSideOf515. Like the show on Facebook, Facebook.com/WestTroopAList. And of course, you can follow me on the Twitter and the Instagram at Wes A-List. Until next time, Troop out.